Hi, my name is Father Dan Cambra, and I'm a Marian of the Immaculate Conception, the religious community that operates the National Shrine of Divine Mercy here in Stockbridge, Massachusetts. And today I'd like to talk to you about St. John Damascene. St. John Damascene, I think, has already had an extraordinarily powerful influence in both the Orthodox and the Catholic faith. But even more extraordinary, I think we have so much to learn from his life. St. John Damascene, obviously, was a Catholic, Orthodox Christian. And St. John Damascene is considered one of the great early doctors of the Church. He wrote numerous books, but the one that he's best known for is his controversy against the iconoclasts. Because within the Christian community, there was a group called the iconoclasts in the early part to the mid 8th century. And these people were influenced by the Muslims that lived around them. Now, St. John Damascene obviously was brought up in his Orthodox Catholic faith by his parents. And extraordinarily enough, they were surrounded by Muslims. And as a matter of fact, his father was the chief tax collector in Syria and worked closely with the caliph for whom he worked. But he was respected, as was John later, by all the Muslims that knew them. It's interesting that they should be in a situation so completely enveloped by Muslims. These days, it seems to be that we can't watch the news without seeing Muslims. But the truth of the matter was, they cooperated and they lived their faith fully. John Damascene, being a sound, understanding philosopher of his time, saw the value in icons, or as we now think of them, as windows to heaven, images of the saints in glory and of our Savior Jesus Christ. And it's important, he said, that we have these images in our homes and in our places of worship so that we might see in them ourselves as well. Holy Mother Church constantly reminds us that nothing can be said about the Blessed Virgin Mary which would not ultimately be possible and true for each one of her children, you and I. St. John Damascene was the one who made it very clear that the idea of removing images from Christian churches was not Christian at all. It was part of the heresy of the Islamic faith. And he identified the Islamic faith as a heresy, as it was a break off from Christianity. Now, his understanding, of course, is tempered within his framework of the history of the humanity at that time. And it's important for you and I to recognize that what happened in the development of the Islamic faith was actually a reaction to Christianity. For you and I, images of the saints, images of God, are important reminders to us of things that they did, things that they said, and who they symbolize for you and I, so that we might follow in their footsteps to even greater glory. St. John Damascene is the one who talked about the importance of looking upon the saints as the giants upon whose shoulders we stand as we reach up to God's infinite graces pouring down upon us through their intercession. St. John Damascene might not be somebody whom you've already been familiar with, but maybe this would be an opportunity as we prepare to celebrate the coming birth of Christ to re-examine how it is that this is portrayed down through the centuries. Because in truth, St. John Damascene is the one who preserved for us many of the early images of our Catholic and Orthodox faith. And it is St. John Damascene who paved the way for art and culture, not only in the church, but through the church into the secular world. When you and I celebrate Christmas, we'll probably gather around a manger, one similar in construction to the one that St. Francis of Assisi made way back in the 12th century. But the truth of the matter is, even more importantly, we go back to all the way to the foundation of our faith through the history of St. John Damascene and see how every image that we have of the saints is merely a glimpse into the glory held in store for us in heaven. Through the intercession of St. John Damascene and the intercession of all the saints, may God bless you and yours.